Hi, this is a minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this week I want to talk about ad mediation networks. Okay, so this week I want to continue on a little bit more what I talked about last week. Last week I showed you my Admob account, and I showed you the difference in revenue between the interstitial ads and the banner ads, that the money that I was making from those. As of this time right now, it goes up and down, it fluctuates. This week I want to talk a little bit about mediation. What mediation is a way that you can use other, many ad networks at the same time. So if you're using Admob within your apps, or MobFox, or one of the many other, ad networks that provide the mediation ability, then what you could do is you could set up Admob to serve ads. But if it can find something that pays better to serve at that time, then it will serve that ad instead. So to talk you through it, so like your app opens up, it's going to display a banner ad, and what Admob will do, or whatever the mediation network will do, is it'll say it has an ad that will pay 10 cents per click, but it could check all the other networks that you have set up, and it could say if MobFox has a better paying ad, then display that one. So have a look at my screen, and I'll talk it through here a little bit more. So here's my Admob page for EarSpy. So EarSpy has Admob in it. So we use Admob for the most part for most of our ads, and the reason for that is a high fill rate. It may not be the best paying one, but it definitely has a higher fill rate. Here you can see that I have the two here. I have banners and interstitials, and I have banners. And I think this banner interstitial, I wasn't sure what that meant last week, but that's pretty much because they have something called smart ads, which, because of all the different devices, it's not just for the banners and for different sizes devices, it can actually change for different sizes. So that's the way that is. So if I go through and I look at, you can see here there's different ad sources. I'll click on this one, and again, I apologize that a lot of this is grayed out, and that's because I'm not sure if the numbers that are here are important. I don't know if anybody could do something malicious besides place ads on my behalf, but I'm doing that. So here you can see the mediation that I have. Now, the default here is Admob, so Admob, most people have it just set up just as that. But here you can see that I've also set up InMobi, Facebook Audience Network, which does really well, but again, a much lower fill rate, and that's because they're much more choosy about who they show to and where they show to. I'm using MobFox, which is not the greatest. And then I have a few house ads here. Now, house ad, if you don't know, is being able to set up your own ads. So because it's your app and it's your app free, and you shouldn't have to pay to put an ad on your app for another one of your apps, or for your business, or for your service, whatever. So every time we have a new app come out, we'll usually put out a house ad for a while and say, do you like EarSpy? You might like Algebra Bubble Bath or whatever. We're trying to make a logical link, right? So you have a few of these here, and you see Adphonic, Flurry, Tapit, and then we got a few others that I've disabled over time. So what this does is it makes it will check to see which one is the highest paying. So here you can see there's this real-time ECPM over here on this column here. Some networks will let Admob find out what the ECPM is at the time, and the ECPM is the estimated cost per click, cost per mil. So it's like the RPM, but slightly different. So like here, InMobi has a real-time ECPM set up, so they could check their API and see, InMobi has better ads at the moment, so we'll serve from InMobi until Admob gets higher or whatever. Now, some of them don't have live ones. So here you can see Facebook Audience Network. For me, I find them to be about £1.80, so I set that manually. Now, every few days I have to check it to see, well, maybe they're not performing as well now, so I have to lower it. Or if they're doing really well, then I want to serve more of those, so I might increase that to give it more prominence. And then the house ads, I may say, if it's going to give me like an ECPM of below like 10 cents or 10p or whatever, then I might want to just say, for me, it's not even worth it for me. Go ahead and show one of my own ads and stuff like that. So So Admob Mediation, or actually, I keep saying Admob Mediation, but MobFox has mediation networks. Flurry, I think, has mediation networks. A lot of the ad networks do. So you basically put their SDK in. You also have to put in the SDKs of the neat mediation networks that you're putting in, but you can use just one of those networks like Admob or MobFox or whatever to control which ones get shown. So it's another way of increasing the revenue. It does spread out the payments to different providers, which is kind of annoying, but it's helpful. So that's something that we've been doing a lot more lately with our app. So that's it for this week. Try out Mediation, see if it works for you, and I'll talk to you next week.
Hey, I really hope you liked that video. Now I do these once a week, so if you want to hear more, or you want to hear more about our experiences with the App Store, either Google Play or iTunes, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel, and please like this video and leave a comment. I love reading the comments. I love hearing what you have to say, even if it's just hello or whatever. And like I say before, if you're not sure what to say in a comment, like I never know what to say in a comment, I'll make it easier for you. Like if you liked it, just go ahead and say gnarly, which is an 80s term. Or if you didn't like it, just say bogus. And if you didn't think any of it, just say eh, right? So that would be a big help. And another thing you could do, which I'd really appreciate it, if you're on the App Store and you want to try one of our apps, look up some of the Overpass apps, applications, either on iTunes or Google Play, and leave a review and let us know what you think about it, either good or bad. But we're all trying to, build up in the market. So that would be a big help. So that's it. I'll talk to you next week.